Kenwyne, obviously, you're back home, a chance to reacquaint yourself with national team and international football. You've come off an injury. Last time you were here on duty, it wasn't such a memorable occasion, but this time around you've been able to overcome that and back in national colours. How it feels?
It feels, you know, really excited to be back within the national setup and being able to come together with the team again. And hopefully this time, you know, this outing will be a much longer outing and injury free.
Right. In saying that, when last we played against England, the team has come a long way since then. We're on the verge of securing qualification to the final round, and the team has gone that distance. With you being there much more in spirit, now you're here, your physical presence is here again, and you're willing to contribute on the pitch, how much do you look forward to adding to the team now?
Yeah, well, you know, I've been out for a while and I've been following all the games and the progression that the team made so far, and it's nice to be here so that I can add what I can to only to enhance the team's performance and the results at the end of the day. Hopefully that will be, you know, pretty positive and it will help us secure the place in the final.
How much of a challenge has it been for you though, as you rightly said, just having to follow all the rehab you've had to go through? And fortunately for all of us, you're back to your, not to your best as yet, but 2 goals in 2 matches is quite a decent record. But what was that period like for you, having to work your way back?
Well, it's a very stressful period, you know, on your mind, more or less, more than anything else. Of course, you have to work on a lot of physical stuff, but it's more a test on your character, more test on your mental strength, you know, seeing how well you can keep yourself together to the time that you do meant to be back. Thankfully for me, I had the shorter stint instead of it being, you know, the full season being out, and I had a lot of people around me, family, friends, you know, the staff of the club, and, you know, just people around me trying to help me get around that, and, you know, making me feel wanted, that, you know, I was coming back to something and they really wanted me back. So it was hard pretty much in the first couple of months, but after that, you know, I started getting into my strides and just working on the day to come back.
What has it been like for you though? In the Premiership, the pace and the hectic schedule of the Premiership, you now as a player, as compared to the last campaign, you were in a division, a lower division, and now you're a marquee player in the Premiership for Sunderland. How has that helped you? What has it been like for Kenwyne Jones of today as opposed to Kenwyne Jones of yesterday?
Well, I think yesterday I was, you know, a bit part player, playing some, missing some, you know, and now I think I've established myself in the league and in my club, so, you know, definitely it helps raise my level of performance, because I'm playing week in, week out, you know, apart from the time that I was injured, but, you know, it could only improve you as a player, playing week in, week out, and, you know, getting that time on the pitch. And I guess so far I've been doing fairly okay, and hopefully I'll be able to do better than that in the future, you know, and move on to even greater heights.
As you're on that note, Roy Keane has gone on record as saying that you've made it difficult for him to leave you out of a starting 11. But at the same time, I'm quite sure he realizes as well that you're making it difficult for some of the other managers to keep their eyes off of you.
Well, at the end of the day, you have to do your best. And if your best is what, you know, keeps at the doorstep of the managers, for not keeping you out of the managers, not taking their eyes off of you, I mean, that could only be good for you. I try not to think about it too much, and you know, I just try to work hard every day and try to do the best that I can with every game that I play, and, you know, keep trying to reach even higher heights in performance so that I can still maintain that, you know, that eye, you could say, that managers keep looking at me, and the manager of my club can't leave me out, because no player wants to be left out, you know, especially in the Premiership. You want to be playing every game, you want to have every minute. So thankfully I've been doing all right and being able to bring something different and something really valuable to the team, that, you know, I can have that effect on him and other managers.
What are some of your ambitions, your goals for the rest of the season? Obviously to try and get among the goals, help Sunderland probably push for something in the top 5, the top 10.
Yeah, well, I'm definitely looking forward to being injury free from now, and, you know, God's willing, hopefully I'll be able to do much better than I did last year, and you know, basically just improve all around as a person, as a player, whether it be for the club or the national team or whatever. You know, we have this game coming up, and the other, once we get through to this, the other round, we have, you know, to try and qualify. Hopefully we could be strong enough and, you know, have everything going for us to be able to qualify for the World Cup, and even after such, you know, propel Sunderland as high up the table as I possibly can.
Looking at Wednesday's game, a lot of people questioned, you know, whether it was necessary for you to just coming back from injury, establishing yourself in the Sunderland team, if we really needed you for this game against Cuba. We understand that you really wanted to be part of the team and make a contribution. And what do you have to say about that?
Yeah, well, you know, people have their opinions. Everyone has an opinion of what should happen, what shouldn't happen, and why it should happen, when it should happen. But for me, I wanted to get back in to be able to, you know, to get a feel even before, you know, we, God willing, we do make it to that final round, because at this point in time, I do need the games, and the more games I have right now is going to help, you know, and it gives me a chance to come back and fall back in, get back in under the eye of the public, the eye of the coaches, the eye of my teammates again, you know, get familiar with them again, and, you know, basically just fall back into the setup of being in the national team. And, I mean, no player, I don't ever want to look back on my career and, you know, have the opportunity to play certain games and do certain stuff and not do it, and then when the time is up, you know, saying I should have been there, and, you know, I was listening to this one and I was listening to the other. I think at the end of the day, you know, I have to look at what is best for me and what's best for my career. So, you know, all the opinions, well enough that, you know, people have them, but at the end of the day, it's only, I think, very few opinion counts.
Come Wednesday, we expecting a victory for Trinidad and Tobago?
Yeah, well, definitely. We're not expecting anything less. But then football is a funny game, but we're going out there with the mentality to win the game, to make sure and secure that final group stage, you know, and hopefully that will come off.
Looking ahead now, once we get to that final round, you've been through a final round of qualification before. You know how hectic, you know how challenging it can be. What are your confidence like in terms of our ability to get to South Africa?
Yeah, well, I think we have a very strong squad. You know, once we have a full squad, I think we have the capability to do anything. We proved it against the USA. You know, it's not beyond our reach. All we have to do is have, you know, a fully fit team, and, you know, once the confidence is going through the team, I think we have enough talent, we have enough experience within the team to be able to, you know, push Trinidad to be able to higher heights.
Great. That's what she starts. Yes.